American rapper Macklemore has pledged to donate the Australian proceeds from his track, Same Love, to the marriage equality campaign. The artist revealed his plans on the eve of the Rugby League final in Sydney, where he will perform the hit song. "I was saying on the car ride over here, I haven't figured it out yet, but I was saying in the car ride over that I want to donate my portion of the proceeds of Same Love that I get off of that record here in Australia to Voting Yes," he told Channel 9. "I need to figure out what that looks like and how to do that, but that is something I am going to do." 9 News Australia at 9 News Aus exclusive. Ed Macklemore has pledged to donate the Australian earnings of his song Same Love to the Yes campaign. Auspol 9 News Pick. Twitter.com/HRV3SFXUAF September 30, 2017. The track has become an anthem for LGBT rights. Its lyrics advocate for inclusion, while criticizing the damaging impact of homophobia and false stereotypes. But its performance at the grand final has drawn the ire of conservatives, who have launched attacks described by some of their liberal colleagues as bizarre. The criticism has been led by former Prime Minister Tony Abbott and Liberal Senator Eric Abetz. Ironically, the controversy helped the track move to the top of the iTunes chart in Australia this week. Gemini at Macklemore. "Yesterday someone started a petition in Australia to ban me from playing Same Love at the NRLGF. Today it's one on iTunes. Love is winning." D. September 28, 2017. Abbott's intervention drew a sharp rebuke from his colleague, Attorney General George Brandis. "It is one of his most popular songs, and for Mr. Abbott and anyone else to say that it should be banned, I think is a bizarre thing to say. I thought Mr. Abbott believed in freedom of speech," Brandis told the ABC. Prior to arriving in Sydney on Saturday, Macklemore said he had been receiving a lot of tweets from angry old white men about his planned performance. That, he said, made him want to go harder when performing the song. He said on Saturday, "Music had the power to start conversations and bring people together. I think that is what music has the power to do, is not divide people, but create an environment where people can start a debate, can have a conversation," he said.